Welcome to clickmyproject.com. Here we discuss about congestion management in deregulated power system by rescheduling of generators using modified differential evolution. Congestion. The overloading of transformer referred to as congestion. The challenging task of system operator is to modify the congestion and to reduce the congestion cost of the rescheduling topologies. Due to this, the delivery of the power transactions to the buyers and sellers are difficult, and also increased cost of the electricity, and it is threatens to the security and stability. To maintain the market efficiency, congestion to be relieved in fast, efficient manner. By this way, generator rescheduling using genetic algorithm based approach proposed in this paper. Using this, identification of minimum cost of rescheduling is preferred. The selected bus system for this proposed topology is IEEE 30 bus system. Disadvantages: it isn't able to handle the non-differentiable, non-linear multimodal functions, and also it isn't suitable for distributed parallel implementation and also inconsistent convergence. So for that purpose, we are going to propose modified differential evolution algorithm to solve the problem of congestion by rescheduling of the generators on the basis of sensitivity factor of the power system. So the non-differentiable, non-linear multimodal functions are carried out, and also it is suitable for the distributed parallel implementation network. The consistent convergence is achieved. System architecture. It consists of four major blocks: IEEE 30 bus system, load flow analysis using Newton-Raphson method, the differential evolution algorithm application, congestion management evolution. First module, IEEE 30 bus system. It consists of 6 generators, 24 load buses, 41 transmission lines. The congestion made by outaging of transmission line and increasing the load at certain buses. Using these two processes, congestions made. Second process, load flow analysis. Newton-Raphson method applied to the load flow analysis technique. Newton-Raphson method is the mathematical technique for solving nonlinear algebraic equations. The real and reactive power flow of a load line calculated using this Newton-Raphson method. Next, differential evolution algorithm application. Initially, the differential evolution is invented by Ken Price. It is a simple and powerful computation tool for evolutionary optimization algorithms. How this workflow has been carried out? Read the data, that is number of buses, slack buses, voltage buses and voltage angle tolerance value. These are all read out. Then formation of Y bus carried out. Then the set iteration count as R is equal to 0. Calculation of instantaneous power and change of power and reactive power, change of reactive power, they are all carried out in this analysis. Computation of Jacobian elements and bus data, line data, generator informations are declared in this module. The determination of excess power flow in the line and bus voltages are obtained. Number of generators, rescheduling power calculated. Here there are three processes. One is fixing the mutation factor. By varying the crossover factor, we can estimate the power flow and congestion cost rescheduling is estimated. Second process, fixing the crossover factor, varying the mutation factor, congestion cost is estimated. Finally, crossover factor and mutation factor both are fixed. By varying the number of population, we can estimate the congestion cost of the rescheduling process. Next, we discuss about the running procedure of our proposed system. Our proposed system consists of one main function, 12 sub-functions. Main function, which comprises the IEEE bus initialization and number of bus datas, number of slack buses, voltage and voltage angle, tolerance value, initialization. So there are initialization parameters are declared in the main function. And bus datas. Our proposed system uses IEEE 30 bus system. So the datas for IEEE 30 bus system obtained here and call the generator data. So this subfunction calls the generator data values to the calculations. Then load flow analysis using Newton-Raphson method is performed by using this function loadflow.m. So this load flow analysis displays the voltage, real power, reactive power, generation of real power, injection of the reactive power, and how much it is to be incremented to provide the congestion. They are all displayed here. And also line flow losses can be calculated using this line datas function. Before going to do load flow and line flow, the Y bus admittance bus generation has to be performed using this subfunction. After performing the calculation of load flow and line flow analysis, we apply the differential evolution algorithm to the proposed system. For that purpose, these subfunctions are used: call objective, cost function analysis, discrete recombination. These are all corresponds to differential evolution algorithm. In differential evolution algorithm, four number of parameters are used: mutation factor, crossover factor, number of populations and generations. There are three cases depending upon the fixing of crossover factor and mutation factor. If mutation factor is fixed to a specified value, then by varying the crossover factor, we can estimate the cost of rescheduling in one case. And also, by fixing crossover factor to a specified value, varying the mutation factor, estimation of cost of rescheduling has to be performed for number of populations. Finally, both mutation factor and crossover factor are fixed. Number of population has to be varied. We get the estimation of cost of rescheduling again. So these are all three cases has to be evaluated, and convergence of differential evolution also plotted. Now I run the main program of our proposed system. The results displayed in displayed window of MATLAB environment here. Here the Newton-Raphson load flow analysis displays the readings for voltage per unit, angle, injection of reactive power, generation of the real power. These are all the values for line flow and losses. Finally, by applying the differential evolution algorithm, the best rescheduled power calculated for 6 number of generator buses here, that are all displayed here. In figure 1, the cost of rescheduling for number of generations has to be evaluated and they are plotted. Initially, it is in the position of above $2,000. After certain number of generations, up to 60 generation, it goes on peak to peak value. When the number of generations increased, the cost of rescheduling is decreased to a specified value after rescheduling of the power. The second figure shows the convergence of differential evolution for number of generations. The fitness function is calculated for the number of generation of 2000 here. Thank you.